The next exercise defines a reserved lane for the compulsory use of the public transport, in this case, a bus. The figure below shows the location of the reserved lanes. So now we will use the template defined reserved compulsory for public lane type. This can be found under the folder Infrastructure Lane Types. So we will apply the lane type only to the ones that we see in the image. So I'll go to this section, I will point my cursor on the rightmost lane and right click, lane type, reserved compulsory for public. I'll do the same for the next section. Here I would like to mention that the user can define his own new lane type and assign a vehicle class that needs to be created beforehand. In the next exercise, we will add 4 bus stops to the network as shown in the next figure. So now I will go to my model and add stop number 1, which is a normal stop type of 12 meters long. On the left bar, I will select the tool Create a Transit Stop and click on the section where the stop needs to be placed. Then I will select this bus stop and make it longer to 12 meters. I will double click on it and see that the type is set to normal by default. Here there are more information that can be shown when this transit stop will be assigned to a public transport line. I can also move the transit stop by holding the left button of my mouse and moving it along the section. Now we'll create the second transit stop, clicking on the left bar on the create a transit stop, and I will create the stop number 2, which is also a normal of 12 meters, and the type is normal. Then stop number 3 on this section, which is 20 meters long, and double click, and the type will be bus bay. So now here I can see that it's using a segregated lane for the bus to stop. Then stop number 4, it's a bus bay, and it's a 30 meters long. Double click on it, type bus bay. I just created the transit stops of my network. In the next exercise, we will define 3 different public transport lines for buses as shown in this graph. The blue one, the yellow one, and the red one. The information about the stops in the routes and timetables for each line is listed in this table. So L blue, L red, L yellow. The L blue will stop to transit stops 1 and 2. The departure will be 5 minutes and the stop time will be 20 seconds. To create a line, I will go to the project again on the menu bar, new, transit, transit line, and then I will see that on the project window, transit lines folder is created with the transit line object with that ID. Here I can double click on it. I will change the name of this transit line to L blue, and then I will add the sections of this line. I can select the sections one by one subsequently, or I can jump some of the sections if I consider that they are following the shortest path. Here I need to assign the stops that this public transport line will make. So in this case, the bus will stop in both of these bus stops, even though the distance is very short. And then I will head on the timetables tab, where I need to import the information that I have been shown before. I need to create a new timetable, which I will give it a name as a weekday. And then on the schedules window, I will push the new to create a new schedule, which will start at 7 a.m. and will last 15 hours. And the interval will be punctual with the vehicle type bus. The time interval between departures will be 5 minutes. By default, it is set to 5 minutes. And in the dual times here window, I will need to set all times as 30 seconds with no deviation. Now I will need to repeat the same process for the other two lines. So now I have created all the public transport lines as in the information that I was provided. Now, when all of the public transport lines are ready, a public transport plan should be generated. I can either generate a public transport plan from Project New Transit Plan, or just go on the Transit folder here and right-click on it and select New Transit Plan. So here I can see that the folder, which is named Transit Plans, has been created with an object included, which is called Transit Plan and the ID. So I will double click on the transit plan object, rename it to PT plan with day, and then I will go on the available transit lines and timetables, and here I can select the corresponding line and the timetable. In this case, I have only one timetable, so I will select the weekday timetables and then press the right arrow here to add the selected timetables in my transit plan. Then I will press OK, and the transit plan has been created. Now, to add the public transport plan into the scenario and run the simulation replication, I need to double click on the dynamic scenario AM that I have previously created and go on the transit plan option and select the PT plan weekday that I just created. So I will press OK, and then I will run the replication in a run animated simulation mode. Here I can see that the simulation has started, but it has paused at exactly 8 a.m. So the difference between the autorun is that the autorun presses the play button automatically. So I will press the play button and I will see the bus is generated, stopping inside public transport stops. And that's it. We have a complete network with traffic demand, traffic lights, public transport to simulate.